नमस्ते बच्चों, खुश रहिए आप लोग। माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर शिल्पश्री शाह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी। आई एम फ्रॉम फैकल्टी ऑफ फिजियोथेरेपी एंड डायग्नोस्टिक्स। सो टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट एबीजी, दैट इज आर्टेरियल ब्लड गैस एनालिसिस एंड रेस्पिरेटरी फेल्योर। ओके, दिस ऑल आर इंटरकनेक्टेड, बोथ ऑफ दिस, दैट एट एबीजी इज ए इन्वेस्टिगेटिव प्रोसेस एंड थ्रू दैट हाउ वी विल डायग्नोज रेस्पिरेटरी फेल्योर, वी विल अंडरस्टैंड दैट। ओके, सो फर्स्ट वी विल लर्न अबाउट एबीजी। वॉट इज एबीजी, वॉट डू इट मीन बाई एबीजी एनालिसिस। ओके, सो एबीजी, ए स्टैंड फॉर आर्टेरियल, बी फॉर ब्लड एंड जी फॉर गैस। ओके, सो द गैसेस एक्सचेंज इन थ्रू द आर्टरी इन टू द ब्लड। ओके, वी ऑल नो दैट ब्लड फ्लोज थ्रू द आर्टरी एंड इन दैट द ऑक्सीजन हैव प्रेशर, द कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड हैज प्रेशर, राइट? सो द प्रेशर ऑफ ब्लड, दैट इज पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ गैसेस इन द ब्लड, वी विल लर्न अबाउट दैट। दिस इज ऑल्सो, दिस इज ओनली कॉल्ड दैट आर्टेरियल ब्लड गैस। ओके, द पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ गैसेस इन द आर्टरी इज नोन एज आर्टेरियल ब्लड गैस एनालिसिस। सो आर्टेरियल ब्लड गैस एनालिसिस इज एन एसेंशियल पार्ट ऑफ डायग्नोसिंग एंड मैनेजिंग द पेशेंट्स ऑक्सीजनेशन स्टेटस एंड एसिड बेस बैलेंस। ओके, ब्लड गैस एनालिसिस इज ए कॉमनली यूज इन डायग्नोस्टिक टूल टू इवेलुएट द पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ गैस इन ब्लड एज वेल एज एसिड बेस कॉन्टेंट। डिसऑर्डर ऑफ एसिड बेस बैलेंस कैन क्रिएट कॉम्प्लिकेशन इन मेनी डिजीज स्टेट्स एंड ओकेशनली द एबनॉर्मलिटी मे बी सिवियर सो एज टू बिकम लाइफ थ्रेटनिंग कंडीशन। ओके, सो वी विल हैव टू लर्न अबाउट एसिडिटी, एल्कलिटी, पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ डिफरेंट गैसेस, ओके, बाइकार्बोनेट। दिस इज द मेन टर्मोनोलॉजी दैट वी विल लर्न इन एबीजी एनालिसिस एंड वी विल हैव टू लुक फॉर दैट। ओके, देन नॉर्मल रेंज एंड वी विल हैव टू डायग्नोज द एबनॉर्मलिटी थ्रू कंपेयरिंग द बिटवीन नॉर्मल रेंज एंड एबनॉर्मल रेंज। ओके, सो फर्स्ट इज व्हाट इज पीएच। पीएच इज द स्केल यूज्ड फॉर स्पेसिफाई द एसिडिटी एंड एल्कलिटी लेवल। ओके, इन एन एक्वस सोल्यूशन, सो इन ब्लड वी हैव टू डायग्नोज दैट द ब्लड इज गोइंग थ्रू द एसिडिटी लेवल और एल्कलिटी लेवल, राइट? सो देन इज पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ ऑक्सीजन। आई हैव टोल्ड यू बिफोर दैट वी विल हैव टू डायग्नोज अबाउट द प्रेशर, पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ गैस इन द ब्लड, राइट? सो फर्स्ट वन इज पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ ऑक्सीजन। सो पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ ऑक्सीजन मेजर्स द प्रेशर ऑफ ऑक्सीजन डिसॉल्व्ड इन द ब्लड एंड हाउ वेल ऑक्सीजन इज एबल टू मूव फ्रॉम एयर स्पेस ऑफ लंग इन टू द ब्लड, दैट इज कॉल्ड परफ्यूशन। ओके, सो वेन द ऑक्सीजन लेवल और पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ ऑक्सीजन, वी कैन से द ऑक्सीजन विल एबल टू मूव फ्रॉम एल्वियुलर एपिथेलियम टू कैपिलरी एंडोथेलियम। ओके, सो वेन इट मूव्स इट इज कॉल्ड परफ्यूशन। सो पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ ऑक्सीजन इज द प्रेशर ऑफ, पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ ऑक्सीजन इज द मेजर ऑफ प्रेशर ऑफ ऑक्सीजन इन द ब्लड। ओके, then partial pressure of carbon dioxide, this same way it is partial pressure of carbon dioxide, measure of carbon dioxide in the arterial blood gas or venous blood. Okay, it often serves as a marker of sufficient alveolar ventilation within the lung. So we, if someone it is called, a question arises that what is the marker of ventilation, okay, ventilation in the lung, so we will say that it is PaCO2, that is partial pressure of carbon dioxide. We will learn diagnose about the ventilation situation of the lung through it and through the level of partial pressure of carbon dioxide. Then bicarbonate, it measures the bicarbonate level in the arterial blood. Next is normal blood gas value. So pH is, we all know that pH level is 7.35 to 7.45. This is normal. Okay. Then normal level of partial pressure of carbon dioxide is 35 to 45 millimeter of mercury. PaO2 is 75 to 100 millimeter of mercury. And bicarbonate is 20 to 26 millimole per liter. Okay. These are the normal blood gas value. Then What are the site of choice to take blood for ABG analysis? First choice is radial artery. Second alternatives are like brachial or femoral artery can also be taken, but the main one is radial artery. You have to remember that. Then assessing blood-based disorder, acid-based disorder. How we will assess that it is in a abnormal state, the patient is in abnormal state through arterial blood gas analysis. So we all have learned about the normal values of blood gas like pH, PCO2, PaO2, bicarbonate, right? So if the pH is less, what will happen? If it is less than 7.35, what it indicates? It indicates towards acidosis. And if the pH level is more than 7.45, it indicates toward alkalosis. Okay. Then, like that, if the PaCO2 increase, then it is acidity. If the PaCO2 or partial pressure of carbon dioxide decrease, then it is alkalosis. Okay. And in bicarbonate, if the bicarbonate level increase, it is alkalosis, and bicarbonate level decrease, it is acidosis. Okay, remember that the PaCO2 and bicarbonate is opposite to each other. Like if PaCO2 increase, it is cause acidosis, but if a bicarbonate increase, it goes toward alkalosis. Okay. Then assessment. So establish whether the patient's pH is acidotic or alkalotic or normal. If the pH is acidotic, that is pH is less than 7.35 and PaCO2 is increased, that is acidotic, then we can say it is a respiratory acidated. We have a mnemonic term, that is ROME, R-O-M-E, okay? We have, how we will diagnose that? There is two conditions, right? Acidosis or it may be alkalosis, right? So, also there are another two terms that separate this also. Okay, one is respiratory, one is metabolic. So in respiratory term, there is also respiratory acidosis, respiratory alkalosis, and metabolic also there is metabolic alkalosis, metabolic acidosis. Okay, so if the pH is acidotic, that is pH is less, and PaCO2 is increased, that is, it is respiratory acidosis. If the pH is acidotic, that is pH less, bicarbonate decrease, then it is metabolic acidosis. Then if the pH is increased and PaCO2 decrease, then it is respiratory alkalosis. And if the pH is alkalotic and bicarbonate is increased, then it is metabolic alkalosis. ROME, remember that ROME stands for R, respiratory opposite hoga. That means pH level and PCO2 level will opposite to each other in respiratory case. Okay, and M for metabolic and E for equal. Okay, in this metabolic case, pH and PCO2 level will equally goes in the same direction. Like if the pH is increased, PCO2 that is pH is increased, that is alkalosis, and PaCO2 decreased, then it is respiratory alkalosis. Okay, fine. So now respiratory failure. What is respiratory failure? It is defined as the inability of the respiratory system to maintain blood gas values within normal range. Okay, there are two types, type 1 respiratory failure and type 2 respiratory failure. Type 1 respiratory failure is defined as the condition with decreased PaO2, hypoxemia, and normal or slightly reduced in PaCO2, okay, due to inadequate gas exchange. It is also called hypoxemic respiratory failure. Why? Because PaO2 will decrease. So hypoxemic, hypoxemia, through this term it is hypoxemic, okay, PaO2 less, that is hypoxemic, okay. So, it is also called hypoxemic respiratory failure. Here, PaO2 level will go less than 60 millimeter of Hg or less than 8 kilopascal. Then, type 2 respiratory failure, it is also called ventilatory failure. I have already told, right, the ventilatory condition is diagnosed through partial pressure of carbon dioxide. So here the main difference between type 2 and type 1 is with PO2 level. Okay, so type 2 respiratory failure is defined as the condition with decreased PO2, that remains same. Okay, PO2, and that is in type 1 and type 2, that is in both case that oxygen, partial pressure of oxygen level will decrease, and in type 2 case the PaCO2 level will increase, but in type 1 that PaCO2 level will decrease or remain same, but in type 2 the PaCO2 level will increase. Okay, so it is called ventilatory failure. Okay, so here PaO2 level will go same as type 1, that is less than 60 kilopascal or 8 kilopascal less than, and PaCO2 level will increase more than 50 mmHg or 6.7 kilopascal. Then what are the causes that may develop respiratory failure? First is condition that make it difficult to breathe in and get air into the lung. Example include following stroke, collapsed lung, and foot getting stuck into or blocking the windpipe, okay, trachea. Or condition that make difficulty to breathe out, like obstructive condition, like chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, asthma, okay. Then lung collapse, so no air is able to enter the lung. One or both lobes may collapse and cause condition called atelectasis. Atelectasis means cell death. Full cell death, okay, lung, the cell of lung will damage fully. Then fluid in the lung like pneumonia, respiratory muscle dysfunction, okay. Then risk factor include age. Premature babies who have neonatal respiratory distress have higher risk of developing respiratory failure, okay. Respiratory distress, what is respiratory distress? Not being able to breathing properly. What the symptom will like? The nasal flaring, okay, shallow breathing or rapid breathing will happen, okay. There nasal flaring is the main symptom. Nasal area will flare, okay. These are the symptoms. Then environment, breathing in lung irritant include air pollution, chemical fumes, asbestosis. Then nerve and muscle disorders such as amyotrophic lateral sclerosis can be the risk factor. Then lung and airway disease like asthma, COPD, I have already told. Then infection such as pneumonia, airway blockage, chest or back injury, okay, severe sclerosis, etc. Then symptoms, what are the symptoms? Low oxygen level and higher carbon dioxide level. There we will divide into two. In low oxygen level, there may be difficulty or extreme tiredness with routine activities such as dressing, combing, walking, okay, taking shower. Then shortness of breath called air hunger, drowsiness, bluish discoloration of lips, finger, okay. Then high carbon dioxide level will cause blurred vision, confusion, headache, rapid breathing, etc. Symptoms of respiratory failure in newborn babies are rapid breathing, grunting, winding, etc. Okay. Then complication arise, arrhythmia, brain injury, kidney failure, lung damage. Why? Because the carbon dioxide, if the carbon dioxide level will high, or if the oxygen, the body does not get enough oxygen, okay, then it may be occur, because the everything for every organ to work, every organ or normally function, it the oxygen level needs properly, okay. So due to that, due to inappropriate partial pressure of oxygen or carbon dioxide or pH level, this organ may can go through damage. Diagnosis may be medical history, look for risk factor or symptom of respiratory failure, okay. Then physical examination, check for cyanosis, as I have told, there will lips, finger, or something will get bluish discoloration, right? So it is called cyanosis, so check for cyanosis. Then auscultation, heartbeat or lung sound can be heard. Then blood oxygen level with pulse oximetry. Here we have to check for the saturation level of oxygen in blood. Okay, blood pressure measurement. Then arterial blood gas test. This is the main diagnostic procedure, I have told. Then blood test to find out respiratory failure. Chest X-ray, bronchoscopy, electrocardiogram, chest tomography, or CT scan. What is there? Then pulmonary function test can be done. Management is antibiotic to treat bacterial lung infections such as pneumonia, bronchodilator to open up the airway so that our airway or lung can get enough oxygen or enough air. Okay, then corticosteroid to shrinken swollen airway, etc. Then physical nutritional support also can be given. Physical therapy include it help to maintain and improve muscular strength and prevent sores from forming. Okay, so movement may also help to shorten the time of ventilatory support and improve recovery. Positioning of the body, we know that in prone position the body will get more oxygen, so we'll take the patient into their appropriate position, right? The preferred position in which the lung get more oxygen, we can go for prone position. So pulmonary rehabilitation or program to educate and teach exercise and breathing techniques, and that can improve the oxygen level of the body. Okay, so this is all about arterial blood gas analysis and respiratory failure. What we have learned today, that what is arterial blood gas, what are the properties of arterial blood, like pH, PaCO2, PaO2, bicarbonate, okay, and then their normal level, what are acidosis, alkalosis, what are respiratory acidosis, respiratory alkalosis, metabolic acidosis, metabolic alkalosis, okay, then what are the different condition in which arterial blood gas level will change, right? Then respiratory failure, what is respiratory failure, what is type 1 and type 2 respiratory failure, then ventilate, what are the other names of that, right? Then symptoms, how to diagnose that, how to prevent them, how to manage them medically and by physiotherapeutic treatment. Okay, so this is all about today's class. If there is any question or any query, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much. Khush rahiye aap log.